Hey guys, welcome back to Mr. DIY's channel. It's Mrs. DIY here, and today we're going to talk all about ESP8266. You can divide the ecosystem into three layers. At the bottom you have the microchip, then above it you have the modules like the ESP01 or ESP12, then at the top you have the boards like the Wemos D1 Mini and Node MCU, among others. We will look at each of these layers in detail. At the center of it all is the microchip. It's a tiny low-cost Wi-Fi chip produced by ESP8266. This microchip uses the L106 32-bit processor and runs on 3.3 volts. It offers 17 general I/O pins, UART communication, SPI bus, software I2C, PWM, I2S with DMA, and one ADC pin. It's worth noting that the Wi-Fi only operates on the 2.4 GHz frequency, and not on the newer 5 GHz, so make sure that you have it enabled on your access point. The ESP8266 chip uses external flash and doesn't have built-in storage. It connects to the flash over SPI using 6 I/O pins. Some come with as little as half a meg to 4 megs or more. The GPIO pins of the chip operate at 3.3 volts and they are 5 volt tolerant. The maximum current that can be drawn from a single pin is 12 milliamps, so pay attention when you are powering external active components. LEDs or communication buses are fine, but anything that needs more current, such as a relay, would require a transistor to power it. If you recall, the ESP8266 chip has a single 10-bit ADC with an input range of 0 to 1 volt. Yes, 1 volt. You can always use a voltage divider to increase this range. Some ESP8266 boards, which we will discuss later, come with a voltage divider that increases this range to 3.3 volts. As you can see, dealing with these microchips is tricky, and it's not really meant for beginners. Luckily, AI Thinker created ESP8266 modules. It basically took the ESP8266 chip and added flash. Some include an antenna, and some are FCC certified. They go from ESP01 all the way up to ESP14, with ESP01 and ESP12 being the most popular. You can load your code to these modules using a serial port, so you will need a USB to serial programmer that looks like this. You can hook it up by connecting RX to TX, TX to RX, power to power, and ground to ground. Just make sure not to use 5 volts because it could get damaged. You will also need to put the module in flashing mode by pulling the GPIO 0 pin low, or connect it to ground before the device is connected. Some modules have custom-made programmers. You can simply plug them in and load your code. Take the ESP01 for example. Rather than doing all the wiring yourself, or accidentally frying it with 5 volts, you can instead use the ESP01 programmer. This avoids any setup hiccups, especially for beginners out there who are learning how to do this for the first time. The link to the product is in the description below. Before we move on, please make sure to hit the subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. Now that we covered the microchip and the modules, it's time to talk about the third layer, the development boards. The ESP8266 development boards include everything you need to build prototypes. They have an onboard USB to serial programmer, a 3.3 voltage regulator, LEDs, buttons, and a voltage divider for the ADC. They are also breadboard friendly. This makes them ready to program out of the box. You can use them to build custom smart home devices. For example, you can monitor the temperature in your house, check the battery level in your car, and play MP3 notifications. Check the description below for project ideas. Some boards, like the Wemos D1 Mini, have easily pluggable components such as sensors, LEDs, and monitors. So now that we have an understanding of the hardware, that is the difference between an ESP8266 board, module, and chip, let's learn how to load the code. The most popular way is to use the Arduino IDE. To configure your IDE, go to Preferences, paste this URL and save. The URL is in the description below. Then go to Tools, Board Manager, and search for ESP8266. Then click Install. And this is how you make your Arduino IDE ready for ESP8266. The next step is to select the board from the list, as shown here. Then connect the board to your computer and click Upload. This brings us to the end of the tutorial. If you're a beginner and you're just getting started with these kinds of projects, my advice is to use development boards since they are easier to work with. In addition to the ESP8266, there are two other boards that are worth mentioning. The first is the ESP8285, which is an ESP8266 chip with 1 mega built-in flash. The second is the ESP32, which is the more powerful sibling of the ESP8266, with built-in Bluetooth and even more functions. So that's it for me. If you'd like to support our projects, you can check out our Patreon page in the description below. I hope this video gave you the information you need to start your awesome projects. Feel free to add your questions or feedback in the comments section. Thanks and bye!